Vampires are a really popular topic in pop culture. They spawned entire series and franchises in books, films, toys, comics, and TV shows. And there are some who have even taken the concept of vampirism to a new level of obsession, attempting to emulate vampiric behavior. Blood is often shown to be the source of vampiric vitality in fiction. It's what vampires depend on most to survive. But what exactly would happen to you if you tried to survive solely on a diet of blood? Well, for starters, as a human, you require water to survive. Replacing water and food with blood would effectively lead to dehydration and would severely upset your body's regular functions. Your skin would dry up, your brain's cognitive functions would slow down. You'd become extremely moody and irritable, and you'd be in a state of perpetual fatigue. After a few days without water, you would die. Simply put, blood alone doesn't contain all of the nutrients your body needs to function properly. Okay, so let's say that in order to survive as an aspiring vampire, you compromised for a diet of blood while still regularly hydrating and maintaining the required nutritional values. So how would regularly drinking blood affect your body? Vampire bats are one of the few organisms on the planet that ingest blood regularly. Their unique physiology, granted through evolution, enables them to rapidly absorb the nutrients found in blood, and then rapidly eliminate the excess through urination. On top of that, their intestines are lined with a membrane of mucus that keeps them from absorbing too much iron. But we're not vampire bats. We humans don't have the same type of digestive systems or evolutionary protection from the large amounts of iron present in blood. And since the composition of human blood isn't meant to be ingested by our bodies, we wouldn't absorb it very well. Sure, blood is essential for life when confined to the areas where it's supposed to be, you know, like your heart and circulatory system. But the fact of the matter is, blood as a beverage is, well, toxic. If you drank more than a pint of blood, you would likely get violently sick. Your body would try everything it could to expel what it would recognize as a toxin from your body. This means you would likely suffer from chronic diarrhea and vomiting. This is because of the large amounts of iron present in blood. We'd be prone to iron overload, also known as hemochromatosis. This type of poisoning can lead to major ill side effects like cirrhosis or a malfunctioning liver, diabetes, arthritis, and testicular failure, to name a few. It would also lead to pancreatic damage, causing an insulin insufficiency that would actually bronze your skin. This means that for those trying to become pale and vampiric, you'd effectively tan your body by drinking lots of blood. Drinking large amounts of blood can also lead to cardiomyopathy, which is a disease of the heart muscle. This means you might experience a shortness of breath, swelling in the legs, feet, and abdomen, general fatigue, and would be at an increased risk of a sudden cardiac arrest. And of course, there's the threat of contracting a bloodborne disease like hepatitis B, hepatitis C, and HIV by drinking blood that might be diseased with certain types of pathogens. The stomach is extremely acidic, but there's more than enough points of entry into your bloodstream if you have any cuts on your lips or inside your mouth. But are there any real-life benefits to consuming blood? A new study from the University of California gave transfusions of blood from young mice to old mice, where researchers observed an improvement in cognitive function. The older mice even displayed better spatial learning and memory. The researchers hypothesized that exposure to young blood has potential rejuvenating effects on synaptic plasticity and overall cognitive function. A procedure known as a vampire facelift takes a sample of your own blood and, after extracting the platelets, injects them back into your face, leading to a temporary reduction in lines and wrinkles. Blood transfusions are also a much-needed medical practice in the world. Whether it be for restoring adequate blood levels to victims of car accidents, sickle cell disease, or even for recipients of chemotherapy or intensive surgery. According to the American Red Cross, every 2 seconds, someone in the US needs blood. However, the positive effects of healthy blood only work when introduced to the bloodstream, not so much the digestive system. So, not only is it unusual, but unless you're a vampire bat, it can lead to liver disease and heart failure. Yet, there still exist individuals in the vampirism subculture who claim to feel reinvigorated, empowered, and more youthful by drinking blood.
Wait, what? Vampires are real?
Yes, Summer, vampires are real.
What's more interesting, there seems to be a population of blood drinkers that aren't interested in vampires. In an article by BBC, a man visited New Orleans to conduct an ethnographic study of its real vampire community. He initially entered with suspicions that the blood feeding was either a religious ritual, a delusion, or a fetish. However, his understanding quickly changed after meeting these individuals. Known as medsangs, short for medical sanguinarians, the act of drawing blood for these individuals is more like a sterilized medical procedure. The article had an interesting thought. Many real-life vampires have no belief in the paranormal and have little more than a passing knowledge of True Blood or Dracula, nor do they appear to have any psychiatric issues. Instead, they claim to suffer from a strange medical condition, fatigue, headaches, and excruciating stomach pain, which they believe can only be treated by feeding on another human's blood. So, we have something of an enigma here. On one hand, science tells us that drinking blood is extremely toxic to the body with a league of harmful side effects. On the other, we have a secret population of blood drinkers who claim it actually helps reduce headaches, irritable bowels, and fatigue. Perhaps the amount of blood drawn from a typical feeding is not enough to constitute the ill effects of an iron overdose. If what the interviewee from the article says is true, and there are thousands of people secretly feeding on blood in just the US alone, there must be something we're not seeing. I've left the article in the description below if you'd like to check it out for yourself. So, what do you think? Would you try a diet of blood? Do you already drink blood? Or have you encountered this hidden community before? Let me know in the comments below. And as always, thanks for watching. Want to see more? Click here to check out the official Darkology playlist.